Does the new budget segment device perform better than the old flagship, and which one offers more value? You might also be having these questions in your mind and might be feeling stuck at choosing between the two, a new budget phone or an old flagship. Well, to share my thoughts on this question, I will be talking about both sides in general. But just for the perspective, I have in my hands Tecno Spark 4 Lite, which is a new budget segment phone, and I will be comparing it to the old flagships like LG G6, V20 or Samsung Galaxy Note 5. And just for the context, all of these are 3 to 5 years old devices. So let's jump straight into the actual topic. Keep watching. Starting with the old flagships, the first advantage you get is the better set of cameras. Even though the cameras on more affordable phones have become way better nowadays, but still, many old flagships have a much better set of camera hardware. In most cases, flagships have higher end lenses and sensors, which enables them to take better photos and videos in almost all kind of scenarios. This trend of versatility continues with the software as well. In almost any flagship camera, you get a variety of features and controls which helps in better experience of photography. But in ideal day light situations, results on both sides are comparable. Despite the fact that the low-end phones lack good camera hardware for sure, but the software tricks enable it to take better photos in daylight just as good as its counterpart. But it is not very good in the category of video recording, while almost every flagship offers 4K video recording. So in terms of camera quality, the old flagships will be a better choice in most cases. By the way, 90% of you watching this video are not subscribed. So please consider subscribe if you like what you see.
Thank you!
Another advantage which you get with an old flagship is its unique and superior design. While to cut corners, manufacturers don't spend as much in research when building a budget phone. They tend to follow a simple template and put only common features. Most of the budget segment phones are very rough looking in terms of design, because in most cases, these are made out of combination of polycarbonate and plastic to save cost. So design is the thing where you clearly see a huge difference in between the two. On the other side, flagships features premium design made out of high quality material such as glass and aluminum. Aesthetically, flagships are more attractive, but budget phones tend to survive drops and falls better because of its polycarbonate shells. Now let's talk about the processor and its performance. In terms of performance, the modern budget phone might have a latest mid-range processor, but when you compare it to the old flagship smartphone, the difference is quite obvious. On day-to-day tasks, both of them might have comparable performance, but if you have to do high-end gaming and perform heavy-duty tasks, then an old flagship with a powerful processor is the way to go. Another advantage, better screens. Despite being released way earlier than the newer budget phone, a flagship phone will more likely to have a better screen in terms of colors, resolution, and overall quality. Flagship phone is more likely to have an OLED display compared to the LCD panels on low-end budget phones. This also means that an old flagship device will have a much brighter and sharper screen with a fantastic viewing angles. Waterproofing is the feature which can be seen on every other flagship, but it is rare in case of budget phones. And that is one of the coolest perks which you get with an old flagship. So you can use flagship phones from companies like Samsung and Apple in the rain or even to record quick videos underwater. Long-term software updates are another benefit of flagships, but unlike Apple, Android devices are not supported for very long term. Like Galaxy Note 5 got 2 major updates but has not received any software update after it was last upgraded to Android 7.0, while iPhone 6s have got the latest iOS update as well. But of course, that's just an Apple thing. So this benefit will truly be valid in case of Apple devices. However, generally it might vary from company to company. Another cool feature which you get with an old flagship is fast charging or wireless charging. While some of the budget phones might have some kind of quick charging, but in case of flagship, almost every phone of them has fast charging support and wireless charging feature as well, which is not something present on low-end phones. Now, with that being said, let's talk about the best things which you can get with a brand new budget phone. Number 1. Bigger batteries. Contrary to flagship devices, Budget phones are generally thicker, which means they have more space for internals, so they often pack bigger batteries. Also, due to the fact that budget devices run on a low-end chipset and do not have high-resolution displays, they are able to last longer on a single charge. The second best thing is to have the latest software straight out of the box. But this trend might vary depending upon the market and manufacturer. So this basically means you won't have to wait for an update to try out new features. Also, on a budget phone, you can get more storage and memory without spending much compared to the flagship ones. For example, the base variant of Samsung Galaxy A51 comes with 4GB of RAM and costs $250, while Infinix Note 7 comes with 6GB of RAM with a significantly lower price. And that's just one example. Last but not the least, with a new budget device, you get a sense of security that your money is not wasted. It is because, in most cases, manufacturers offer replacement or some kind of warranty for their every new phone. That's it for today, guys. I hope you liked the video, and if you are watching until now, then press the subscribe button as well. It would be really helpful. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.